Welcome to a day in the life, a day in the life of the Scrandon, a day in the life of me as an online coach. Now that I'm an online coach, I think people think I'm just sitting down at my laptop and, yeah, just playing COD all day pretty much, but no, that's not the case. I'm a busy guy, I'm going to take you through what a typical day looks like, and not only a day as an online coach, but I'm also doing a photo shoot prep as well. I think I've got about 3 and a bit months left. I'll leave what I'm kind of currently looking like right now, and I'm getting happier, you know. I'm starting to see some kind of nice changes, like every day, kind of week in, week out. I'm also seeing some nice scale weight drops as well. So I was 72.1 kilo today, and the end of my last diet last summer, I was 71.9 kilo. So I've still got like 3 months, I would say. I'm probably in a better position the way I look now than I was at the end of my last diet, and I'll put them up on the screen as I'm talking. So I'm pretty excited, man. I'm going to be in the best shape that I've been in for sure, like ever. The coach that I'm working with thinks I'll probably get down to about 62 kilo, which is insane. It is absolutely insane. It's obviously light, but I'll be absolutely shredded, fucking diced out my mind, man, and I'm so, so excited for it. Really, really buzzing for it, because I've never really been shredded before, like, ever. It means that when the diet finishes, I'll be, like, super, super lean, which means I can really, really put a good, good focus into doing, like, a proper gaining phase. Before, when I've tried to do gaining phases or bulks, I've just got fat, I've just been lazy, I've just been like, fuck it, I'm bulking. I'm not like the kind of guy that can just eat hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and stay lean. I will just get fat. So I wake up about 6 in the morning, go to the toilet, I weigh myself, and then I'll just get myself ready and head straight to the gym for my fasted cardio. There's always a big debate, like, is fasted cardio better than doing non-fasted cardio? I think it is, to be honest. Like, I think just going in, like, empty stomach, you have a coffee, so basically the point of it, it's just a black coffee, so basically the point of that black coffee is just taking a, elevate your heart rate, spike that, and then it means that when you go in and do cardio, you've already got like an elevated heart rate, and yeah, you'll get more of a sweat on, basically, and it just helps to push you through, because I've literally just woke up like half an hour ago, and I'm going in to do like 35 minutes on the Stairmaster, and shit on it, it's fine, do you know what I mean, it's fine, like, and after that, see, driving away from the gym and it's like whatever time, 7:30, and you've got a proper sweat on, and you know that people are still sleeping, you feel amazing. Does that make sense? So I know that sounds like the cliche kind of PT thing to say, but see, when you're in first thing in the morning getting a sweat on, like working hard, and you know that people are just still in bed sleeping, it makes you feel like, I don't know, mentally elite.
Yeah, good cardio session. I've been doing like TikTok lives when I've been doing my cardio, just because people are firing away questions. It's like a Q&A, but it makes the cardio go so quickly. Like, I can't believe I've just done 35 minutes there. It's crazy. But my hungry boy on my way home, munch. I also, what am I doing? My way home, get a munch, do some check-ins, and then I'm taking my wee gran out for a coffee. How wholesome. Then what am I doing? Get a session. Get legs today, get legs, and then I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm just talking shit now. I'll see you back in the house.
Done that, nah. They don't understand, I'm giving them UK stand. My brother, my fam, my act. You say the feds just gonna sweep. You say the boy, they're running my gaff. In London, I'm verified. In NY, I'm valid. 12 hours away, I'm MIA. I can pull up on DJ Khaled.
Central C is unbelievable, man. Unbelievable. Of things that I like to eat before a leg session, I really, really, really do not like to have a big meal at all before legs, to be honest with you. I just feel like I can't digest it properly, and then not even digest it properly, but I just hate going into legs with such a heavy feeling stomach, so I keep it nice and light. So I'm literally just going to scan 2 Pop-Tarts now. I posted a YouTube Shorts about this maybe like last week. Depending on what country you live in, you might not have heard of something called an Empire Biscuit. There's strawberry sensation Pop-Tarts. But I don't like to put them in a toaster. See if you bang them in the freezer and just eat them, like take them out of the freezer and eat them straight, they taste exactly like this Empire biscuit. But the calorie macros are all right in them, like for two of them it's 400 calories, but you're getting 70 gram of carbs and it's only like 9 gram of fat, which is not too bad. So it's not as if you're eating like a big massive meal, again a nice kind of sugary carbohydrate, it's going to go into the bloodstream really really quickly and get ourselves set up for the leg session. So take them out of the freezer, it's just what a standard Pop-Tart looks like if it focuses. And that's not going to focus, is it? Yeah, you can see what it is, it's just a standard Pop-Tart, literally straight out of the freezer. It just tastes exactly like an Empire biscuit. It is absolutely peng. So I'm going to make this and then I'm also going to have a big yogurt bowl as well, so I'll show you that. Also, another thing that I wanted to announce. What am I trying to look for? Hold on. I am the new ambassador for Skinny Food. Come on. New brand that I'm going to be working with. So expect a lot of recipes, a lot of kind of like desserty recipes. Yeah, I'm really, really excited. Skinny Food are going to be an absolute lifesaver for me, especially when I'm doing this photo shoot prep and this diet. They've so many different things, different like low calorie like sauces, all extremely low calorie. Get coffee stuff as well. So like different coffee creamers and coffee flavourings that you can put in your coffee, obviously. And then also look at this, right? See when I'm actually allowed to drink alcohol again. Look at these. So it's basically skinny mixers. So see if say you were having like a sex on the beach on holiday. A normal sex on the beach would set you back like hundreds of calories, right? Whereas this is like, it tastes like a sex on the beach and all you really need to add is the vodka to it, but you're going to be saving like so much calories. So let me see how much is in this. 75 ml serving, so like a kind of, whatever, standard serving. Two calories and it tastes, let me smell it actually. It literally tastes, and, well, I don't know about the taste, but it literally smells like a sex on the beach, which is class. So these are definitely going to get abused when the warm weather comes back and I'm allowed to drink again. Like, I'm going to be having like Greek yogurt before the gym, but a lot of the times Greek yogurt kind of tastes like ass a wee bit, so things like this will come in handy. There you go. Things like this are going to come in absolutely clutch. So we've got like skinny flavouring, so you basically just put a few wee drops of this into things like a yogurt or anything, or like coffee or anything, and it makes it taste like that. So yeah, I'm absolutely buzzing. You can use my code ADAMDON at the Skinny Food checkout for a nice wee discount. And yeah, like I said, it's going to be an absolute lifesaver during my photo shoot prep. Like, I'm always looking for things that taste good but are extremely low in calories, and that's what the whole brand is about. So I'm absolutely buzzing. I'm absolutely buzzing to get up and running. I'm buzzing to get some good recipes out there as well. And yeah, it's a company that I've used like multiple times before, especially for like the coffee stuff and that. So yeah, I'm really, really excited. Another big move, another brand deal. And yeah. The future's looking bright or whatever, yeah. I'm still packing the oh, that's still recording. Bitches ain't shit and these buttons still broke. Walking with the limp, just like a pimp. They know I'm the shit and they know I'm the hoe. I was left to climb a mountain with rope and I did it arranging some alphabets. Couple of mil from some alphabets. Time equals money, no time for those. You're doing this money, but know when I'm juggling. Six figure bookings, you can't have a piece of this pie, but it can't have a taste of this life. Got a phone and put a weight on it. I made some money and they fucking hate on me. I carry burners like it's fucking weight on me. The 38 is on me. Don't be playing around too much. Give 10 to my wife, tell her dress up and meet me for lunch. 23k to the lawyer, defend me in front of the judge. 60 milliliters of mud got me. The 38 is on me. Don't be playing around too much. Give 10 to my wife, tell her dress up and meet me for lunch. 23k to the lawyer, defend me in front of the judge. 60 milliliters of mud got me. My wife a 10 out of 10, her father should've asked for a meal for the dowry. I'm the reason why they post in the neighborhood, watch stickers round the county. Bread on his head was the bounty. 190 on the dash, Brody just pulled up in the Audi. 7 hour flight to Saudi. Change up my money to bricks and some water. Whip up a brick and I whip with some water. You ever sat up in court, only that kind of awkward man, I shouldn't be here. Fendi skis out in Swiss. Skis
slope on my wrist. Diamonds dancing like a money mitch. Half a key of coke, get you hit.
The 38 is on me, yeah. Don't be playing around too much.
What a session with the boy Lewis. A tough one. I feel like Legs, like, it always proper takes it out. You see, after like a good heavy hard session like that, it proper takes it out. You after, like, I'm ready to go to bed. We don't stop grinding. We never stop grinding. Quite a lot of clients to set up, so we've now officially hit 40, just under 45 clients, which is crazy because I was on like 20 in December, so the team has grown massively and everybody's smashing it, and yeah, it makes my job amazing. I just feel like I've got the best job on the planet. Okay, this one is definitely not making the TikTok or the YouTube shorts or anything because it kind of looks like a dog's dinner, but you can see how big these wraps are and they're super, super tasty. So I'm going to scram this and then get to the setups. Granny!
Yes, sir!
Come on! say hi to the YouTube. Say hi to the YouTube, Gran.
Hi there to the YouTube.
Yes, yes.
Sitting beside my grandson.
I've got a question for you.
Oh God, this will be good.
What do you think the most optimal training split is for hypertrophy, and do you think fasted cardio makes a difference to not doing fasted cardio?
I don't really know if my opinion would count for very much because I've no idea what you're talking about.
And Gran, another question.
Right.
Are you proud of me?
So proud.
Yes.
So proud. Yes. Every time I say, oh, and I get all emotional.
Don't get emotional,
right? You know what I'm like? Good job, I could have put mascara on.
Yes, the trim. Looking fresh. Look at those cat scratches. Come on. Shout out to JJ's and Renfrew, the absolute goats. Feel so much better with a haircut. And what a day it's been, you know. Fasted cardio, good couple of scrans in, mate, check-ins. What else have I done? Legs, wee coffee with a grandmother, now a fresh trim, and I'm already. I'm so tired today, I've done so much work. I don't want that to sound like, oh, I've done so much work, look at me, but yeah, it's been a very, very busy day. It's been a bit mental recently, I'm not going to lie, so I wanted to quickly kind of talk about my online coaching, because obviously a few of you will know me through like maybe TikTok, or you've maybe seen my recipes on YouTube Shorts, or you've maybe just seen one of my actual YouTube videos so far and subscribed, and if you have already, thank you so much, and if you've not, what are you doing, subscribe, get involved and help me get to 1k, please. To talk about the online coaching and just give you an update about me and what's been going on really in my life. So I basically started kind of obviously doing like social media, TikTok, maybe about like April, May time 2022. Again, I've kind of like spoke about this before, but it picked up, like it did pick up pretty well, and yeah, I've got a decent following on TikTok now. And yeah, the Instagram's picked up as well. So that was 2k followers at the end of November on Insta. Now I'm shy of like 8k, which is kind of nuts as well, quite mental. Maybe not the main one, but one of the ones that I really, really want to grow is the YouTube. I really want to, I've got so many like good ideas in mind and so many things that I want to do. So it'll be good, and I know it's coming. I just need to be patient because I'm like one of these guys that really, really wants everything to happen like right away. So yeah, I'm sure it's coming, but so yeah, started picking up massively, and then basically a company got in touch with me called Linus. So basically all your kind of favourite fitness influencers and everybody like that, a lot of these people will be with Linus. So like a lot of these people work with this company. So they basically approached me. They've approached me for a while, but I thought they were like kind of one of these people like, oh, hey man, we can like scale your business and all that. So I just kind of ignored them. And then I remember like I was kind of not getting fed up with the one-to-ones, but like I really, really wanted to just kind of really drive the online PT side of things more. So I remember I went down to my car one day and it was like pishing, peeing down with rain, 5 a.m, freezing, like going into the gym, and I was just like, nah, let's go on a call. So basically I now have a mentor called Nick Walsh. I honestly love him to bits, man. He's the soundest guy ever, and he's been amazing with me, and he's helped me grow my business like massively. And yeah, like everything, this is what I'm saying, like it's picked up like a lot and quickly, and I'm so, so excited. So basically started with them in December, and I think I had like 20, I was on 21 clients on the 20th of December, and today's date, It is the 16th of February and I'm on 45 clients, which is kind of insane, quite crazy, to be honest with you. So a lot of people to look after. But I wanted to talk about like some of my clients. So I do believe that if you're going to a PT, like you need to know that the proof is in the pudding, like they know what they're talking about. I wouldn't go to a coach that didn't really have like any transformations. And I don't know, I think like it's a bit of a kind of red flag when you go in a coach and like all the like feed is literally just them and no clients. So I'm like one of these people, I'm not just like a PT that's here to take your money off you and then just give you a plan and then you never hear from me ever again. Like, I very much want to get you to where you want to get to, and I thrive off it. I really, really get a buzz off it, and yeah, it means the world to me. Like, not only seeing people change physically, but seeing like the kind of newfound confidence that comes with that, and overall improving like their quality of life as well, is a massive thing to me. And I genuinely do seriously care about every single one of my clients, and I'm looking after like a lot of people now. It's a lot of lives, a lot of different lives, a lot of responsibility. People put their trust in me, and I'm honoured to help people out to really kind of get them to where they want to get to. But I'm always a PT as well. Like, I'm not one of these kind of personal trainers that's so out of touch with reality and thinks everybody needs to eat chicken and rice to lose weight. I'm very much a lifestyle coach. I live a balanced lifestyle. I preach it. I try and install that into all my clients, and I want them to make, yeah, amazing progress. And don't get me wrong, they might need to make some sacrifices, but I want them to get to where they want to get to without having to like restrict ourselves or give anything up or don't do things that they enjoy, pretty much. So yeah, like I've obviously had my app developed for me. I'll just kind of leave it running on the side here and I can like kind of talk through it. But yeah, there's literally so many different things on it. You'll be doing like weekly check-ins with myself, so it's good. Again, like, I'm not here just to throw a plan at you and you never hear from me. I like having that interaction. I like having that kind of that contact with you and making sure that you know what the plan is going forward and that you really have a good solid understanding of it, so that we can really, really nail it and get you to where you want to get to. And I want to do it in the most enjoyable and the most sustainable way possible as well, and that's what I always try and get across. And I'll leave some client transformations up as well, like of people that are absolutely killing it. But these people have done this by like not eating like a rabbit and not doing hundreds and hundreds of cardio. They've been doing it by enjoying foods that they like tasty high protein meals and stuff like that, and using my recipes, because I'm a big believer in if we're actually enjoying the foods that we eat, then we're 10 times more likely to stick to it, and it's not going to feel like a diet, and we're going to have so much less temptations to go off track and binge and get takeaways and go out for food and stuff like that. So by like simply taking out ingredients and by swapping them and substituting them, we can make meals lower in calorie, lower in fat, higher in protein, but still lose just as much fat as compared to if you were just eating plain chicken and rice every day. I'm a big massive believer in that. So yeah, everybody does it in a sustainable way. There's over 60,000 recipes on the app, all very, very tasty. Again, it can make it work wherever you're from in the world. Like, I'll actually have a database to cover everything, so you don't need to be in the UK to inquire with me. Yeah, if anybody fancies it, anybody wants to come on board, then please do. So yeah, I would love to have you on board, and especially grow the team globally as well. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the full day in my life. It's been a busy, busy day. A lot of work got done, a lot of sessions, catch-ups and stuff like that. But this is what a typical day in my life looks like, and I love it, and I would not change it for the world. And yeah, I appreciate it. So if you've stuck around this long, thank you so much. Like the video, hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Help me grow this channel in 2023, and turn my notifications on, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.
To my wife, tell her dress up and meet me for lunch. 23k to the lawyer, defend me in front of the judge. 60 milliliters of mud got me. The 38 is on me, I don't be playing around.